Hello everyone, and welcome to part 3, your first JavaScript exercise. Let's get some practice with your new skills. You're going to be creating a very simple website that takes in a weight in imperial pounds and converts it to kilograms. The HTML is already done. All your work will just be in the connected .js file. And the relevant files can be found under JavaScript Level 1 folder, and they're called part3_exercise.html and part3.js. So at the bottom of that HTML file is the connection to the solution.js file, which is part3.js. Make sure to actually change that to your own .js file before you start. Let's quickly explore the HTML file and what this exercise actually looks like. I'm going to hop over to the editor and browser now. Okay, here I have my editor open as well as the browser connected to the HTML file. And the instructions for the exercise are actually already embedded into this HTML file. Like I mentioned, you're going to be creating a weight metric converter, taking a number in pounds and convert it to kilograms. And what you're going to be doing is at first, you need to grab this HTML file, and all the way down at the bottom, we have the script. And the reason the script is at the bottom is because I want all this HTML to load before my script actually loads. So I have this script here, and right now it's connected to my own script, myscript.js. But when you first open this file, it's going to be connected to part3.js. That is the solution JavaScript file. So if you want, you can run this HTML page one time so you can see what the solution looks like as far as its interaction with the website. But make sure when you're actually programming your JavaScript, you remember to change the source to your own solution. Okay, so like I said, you first want to actually change the script here so it links to your work. Then use JavaScript to accept a number input in pounds. Then in your JavaScript file, convert this number to kilograms, and the conversion from pounds to kilograms is right here. You multiply it by 0.454, and then afterwards report back in an alert that the weight is now in kilograms, and then log/write conversion completed to the console. So I can see here conversion completed in the console. Let me refresh the page and show you what this should all look like once you've come up with your solution. I'll refresh, and we see here it says what is the weight in pounds, so I'll put in 100 pounds, click OK, and then it reports back that is 45.4 kilograms. I hit OK, and down here at the console, I see conversion completed has been logged. All right, this is a fairly simple exercise. It's actually just a few lines of JavaScript code. If you get stuck on anything, feel free to post to the Q&A forums or just watch the next lecture where I will code through the solutions. Thanks everyone, and I'll see you at the next lecture. Hello everyone, and welcome to the Solutions lecture for the first JavaScript exercise in Part 3. Let's hop to the editor and get started. Okay, so here I have my text editor of the HTML document open, and I've linked it to myscript.js, and myscript.js is currently empty. So right now if I refresh this page, nothing actually happens. So let's actually add in the logic that we need to convert this. So I'm going to create a variable, LBS for pounds, and I'm going to set it equal to the prompt, which asks weight in pounds question mark. Then what I'm going to do is create another variable called kilograms or kg, which is equal to the variable LBS or pounds times 0.454. And then I'm going to alert the user that is, and let's concatenate it with the kilograms, kg, plus, and then say kilograms. And note my spacing here, that way it actually reads nicely. And let's add some semicolons here, and we're going to talk more about semicolons later on. It's actually not necessary to have them here on each line, but it's good practice. And then we're going to add in a log to this. So if you just start typing log, you'll actually get the whole console.log there. And I will say conversion complete. So now let's refresh this page and see what happens. It says weight in pounds, I'll say 100 pounds. It tells me it's 45.4 kilograms, I hit OK, and I get conversion complete at the bottom. And that's really all there was to it. So again, just four lines of JavaScript, and hopefully now you feel really comfortable setting a variable, using prompt, using alert, and using console.log. If you have any questions, feel free to post to the Q&A forums. I'll see you all at the next lecture.